Hello, welcome to the ideaofaman.com podcast. My name is Omar Zach Phillips and I'm so glad you found me. Today we're going to be talking about business, and this comes on the back of a bit of a journey that we've been going on. We're going to continue this journey throughout the entirety of 2021. I'm very proud of myself. I've been getting up every weekend and sitting in front of my camera and recording these podcasts, and also turning those into podcasts so they can be available on all the podcast platforms out there, but also putting it out there on YouTube as a video so you can watch me as well. So the ideaofaman.com is my writer's blog, whereby I'm doing a couple of things. Obviously I'm blogging and telling you a bit about my life and my journey as a man, as I sort of go through the process of developing my idea of a man for myself. But I'm also encouraging you as an individual to discover for yourself your unique idea of a man. Who are you as an individual? Go on that journey for yourself. And to facilitate that, I've created a 12-step process, which is called the Idea of a Man Project. And there's material on there with articles and obviously with the videos and the podcasts that I'm making as we go through this process. We literally started in January. For that first quarter, we laid a foundation so that you can build your idea of a man. In order to do that, we asked in January, who am I? In February, where then do I fit? And then in March, we looked at how do I survive being me on the earth? And sort of taking that theme forward, we're now going to look at how we can fund the enterprise, which is our lives. And so in the month of April, we're going to be discussing business. And we did the first one of these podcasts last week, where we literally talked about taking care of business. And now we're going to be talking about being a businessman. And I want to talk to you about this concept really from a few different angles. So one of the things we talked about briefly when we spoke last week was the material that's been put out there by Robert Kiyosaki in his book Rich Dad Poor Dad, which I'll leave a link to below this podcast, because it's quite a useful book, particularly from a paradigm perspective. And the reason why I'm sort of using what he calls the four quadrants in the things that I'm going to be talking about is because in the idea of a man, the concept that I'm talking about a lot is the fact of a journey where you're going from point A to point B, and it's really good to get out a pen and paper and to plot yourself on that sort of journey from where I am now, being A, to where you're going, point B. And to take inventory, basically, of the things, the resources, the tools that you're going to need to accomplish the point B, to achieve your goals and objectives and get yourself from where you currently find yourself to where it is long-term you're trying to get to. So in light of that, I find that Robert Kiyosaki's four quadrants are a useful barometer, really, that from which we can look at our lives and consider where we are on a spectrum from a business perspective. Now, he basically breaks it down into four different unique parts, the first being an employee, the second being self-employed, the third being a business owner, and the fourth being an investor. And in a sense, it's a kind of a journey, unless obviously you win the lottery and you're able to jump straight into the position of being in the investment category. But if you're in the ebb and flow of normal day-to-day life, then basically what we need to do is to know where our starting point is, where we currently find ourselves, and how we're going to develop wealth, how we're going to get to a point where we are, you know, flying on all cylinders, as it were. So with that in mind, I want to talk to you about being a businessman. And I want to talk to you whether you find yourself currently in a position of employment, or if you are an investor. You know, wherever you are on that spectrum, the mentality of a businessman, of handling your business, of taking care of business, is really going to be key to whatever it is that you're doing and the way in which you're doing it. We spoke a lot with regards to, when we laid the foundation, finding yourself and discovering that unique you. Because it's so important that you are true to yourself, that you're authentic, that you know who you are. Otherwise, you do things because other people, you know, want you to do them. So you're looking externally for impetus with regards to why you do what you do, which, you know, will keep you going for a little while, but eventually you begin to run out of steam. The sages of the ages, as it were, the wise men from back when, have always told us that it's from within, that power is from within, that God is within, or, you know, the sources of our strength as individuals. That, you know, when you find yourself in a debilitating situation, you need to look within and draw from what's within side of you to marshal the resources to be able to be all that you need to be. And why that's important is because actually your identity and who you are is intrinsic to who you are is within. As a matter of fact, the universe, as it were, is within. The whole array of everything that's, you know, there's so much there. You know, we'll talk about that when we get into spirituality, which will be further down the road, but we're not talking about that right now. We are talking about that authentic you. And when you're doing what you're doing, you're building a life for you that has meaning to you. The idea of a man is here to address like the harrowing statistics that are out there with regards to male suicide, male incarceration, drug abuse, and all the negative things, which when you read between the lines, I see male aimlessness. I see that there's a big issue with us not having a purpose, not having an aim, living our lives, you know, being swayed by the wind, you know, not being sort of set about anything because we're not sure about who we are. Society has a bunch of messages with regards to what we should be, and there's a lot of shoulda, coulda, wouldas. There's a lot of, you know, you should be this and you should be that and whatever the case may be. But, you know, who are you as an individual? You know, the women's movements and things of that kind have gone to a place where that's been intrinsic to their way of looking at life, and that's been really good because they've evolved and developed themselves and invested in themselves. But unless we do the same, then we're going to find ourselves sometimes in positions where we just feel hopeless, we feel aimless, we feel like life for us hasn't got a point. And so this is a big part of what I'm doing in The Idea of a Man, is really to enable you to see that there's so much point to your life, there's so much of an aim to who you are. Who you are as a man is valuable, and your value first of all rests in your value to your own self. And once you establish that for yourself, then you know you can express that value to others. You can give your life as a gift to the world. You can give your life as a gift to your lover, to the people who are in your life. And that's really so important, to really understand that you are a gift and you've got so much to give. So from that perspective, when we're talking about funding the enterprise, which is your life, about, you know, handling your business and taking care of business, this is where we get down to the nitty-gritty, the practical matters that enable you to live a life that's meaningful and fulfilling when you're doing the hard work of whatever it is that you find employment in. So if you are self-employed, the idea of being a businessman and approaching it from that mentality and from that perspective, we're dealing a lot with the way we approach things from the mind, changes things. Because if you're, you know, being employed by another person, you oftentimes become a little bit dependent upon that paycheck. So you do your work and they pay you. But what if that stops? For example, they go out of business, or, you know, you lose your job, you did something wrong, you get sacked, or whatever the case would be, or you face redundancy, or because of illness or something else, some other situation occurs, and as a result, you're no longer able to be employed with that employer. When you find yourself in that situation, that can be very hard on a man. And if you've got no backup plan, if you've got no bigger picture, no bigger way of looking at the world, your life and your place in it, then you find yourself in a pickle, to be honest. So the imperative thing, when you approach it as a businessman, you're not entirely dependent upon them. Your life is actually dependent upon yourself. So if you lose that job, you get up in the morning and you go out and get another one. Why? Because you're handling your business. Because you're not doing this for them. You're not doing this to build their business. You're building your empire. The work that you do on a day-by-day basis is for you. So the whole perspective is, what are you building for you? What is the aim, the vision, the mission that you're out here accomplishing, whether you're employed or whether you're employed yourself, whatever the case may be. Now, obviously, you may be a person who, because of the nature of your career and what you're choosing to do with your life, you're not ever choosing to come out of that situation. You see yourself as being employed for the rest of your life, and that's absolutely fine. Or you may be a person who has another aim, who knows that you have to do this to handle the bills, but at the end of the day, there's something working within your soul, some deeper purpose, some higher calling, as it were, that you know that you're going to have to fulfill if you're ever actually going to fulfill what you were put on planet Earth for. And I'm going to speak to you briefly now. So you may not be in a position where, from a financial perspective, it's realistic to just kind of ditch it all and go and do your creative thing. But if that is your aim, if that's your passion, if there's something within you that knows that if you're doing that all day, every day, you wouldn't even feel like as if you were working per se. But you know there's many people out there who are earning a living out of doing exactly what it is that you love, but at the precise moment, perhaps it's not yet possible for you. What I encourage you to do is, like what David Deida says, each day, take out at least an hour a day, at least an hour a day. If you could do more, to spend some time honing your craft and developing yourself. This whole thing has been about investing in yourself. Invest in books, invest in the relationships that you have that are going to enable you to get from A to B. Invest in courses, invest in whatever it is you need to invest in yourself to develop who you are and enable you to kind of keep pushing the needle towards your objectives, towards your goals, and towards your aims. So really get to know yourself and to know what it is that you're going to need in order to be able to achieve your objectives, and then begin that journey. even if you never even fully accomplish all the things you'd like to accomplish, the point is you're on the road, and the things that you engage in on a day-to-day basis are going to be so much more fulfilling for your life than if, say, you just spend all your time and energy doing just a 9-to-5 for us per se. I mean, some of you are going to absolutely love your 9-to-5s. You're in a fantastic job. You're enjoying it all day long. But for many of us, it's just a means to an end. It's just a way that we pay our bills. And when that's the case, sometimes you know that there's more to you. There's more, you know, I keep on saying it, you know, don't compare yourself against anybody else, but compare yourself against your own potential. But when you look at yourself and you know that I have potential for more, there's more working within me. Perhaps there's a book within you that needs to be written, you know, a musical composition that needs to be created. I don't know what your thing is, but you need to search within yourself and find that thing that you're here to do. And you need to take out the time to invest in yourself to bring that thing out as a gift to the world. Because also in that process, you're going to gain fulfillment out of the accomplishment and achievement of doing what you're ultimately here to do. So that kind of is the process where you're working on yourself so that you can get yourself to a position where actually now you're self-employed. You're employing yourself to do the thing that you love, to work on your passion, to work on your gift, etc. Now that's all well and good. But, you know, eventually you're going to realize that if you get ill, you know, then the work stops and you don't earn money. So how do you get to a place where you can rise beyond that stage? You're going to have to start employing people. So hopefully you can begin to generate a decent income out of what you're doing, and you can begin to employ others to help with the work, and then the work will continue on. And now you're a business owner. So you're in the third of the four quadrants. Well, I'm encouraging you in that process, actually throughout the whole thing, to have this mentality in your whole approach as being a businessman. Invest in appreciating assets. Don't invest your time, your energy, and resources in depreciating liabilities. Why? Because the more that you invest in appreciating assets, the more you're moving the needle towards that final stage of this four quadrants, which is to become an investor. The investment mentality is something you're building up. You're developing it as you go along. You're doing it in your day-to-day life. You're not investing your time and your energy and money in things that basically are just a complete and utter waste of money. You buy them, and the moment you have, they depreciate entirely. You know, when you buy depreciating assets like, say, food, for example, where nobody's going to spend more for your food than you paid for it originally, you're investing in yourself because you're investing in fuel. You're buying things that are going to help you to live a healthy, constructive, and creative life. But if you're buying just junk for the sake of it, just living a materialistic life where you're just chasing the Joneses, buying the stuff that, you know, your friends are buying because you're trying to, you know, look the same as them, do whatever they do, then, you know, you could be more creative than that. You can actually adopt it and have a style as opposed to just following fashion and having to have the latest, you know, trainers or whatever the case may be. Do things that are creative. Think outside that box. Think more about your life and about who you are. You know yourself, you know? And in that process, invest in things that are going to give you a return on the investment so that when you sell them, you're going to make more money. Doing that all the way through, you get to the point where now you're a business owner. As a business owner in your business, invest in things that are going to give you a return on your investment. And then what's going to happen is you're going to begin to have a surplus of money. You take that money and you begin to make that money work for you. So you invest it basically into enterprises, whether that's another business, and then you make it better. And as a result of that, you can then sell it for a profit, or whether it be real estate, which often, you know, just by default of its location or whatever the case may be, is sometimes able to gain equity. Whatever the case may be, invest your resources in appreciating assets. So then you'll get your money working for you. And the more that begins to become a reality in your life, the more you begin to put yourself in a position where you can sit back and retire, as it were, because your money is literally doing what needs to be done. So those are the four quadrants. And, you know, from a perspective of going on a journey as a man, you know, developing yourself, having a business perspective, or, you know, throwing that into the equation of your personal development, your personal process, is really going to help you as a man to begin to live a more independent, more meaningful life, a life which is going to be funded, you know, a life that's going to have the resources that you need to get you from A to B. Now, I'm going to speak briefly to the person who's out there who is actually unemployed, whose life, the wheels have fallen off the bus, as it were. You know, you're coping, you do whatever you do, but perhaps you're not coping so well. If you find yourself in that type of situation, you know, if, say, you were overweight and you decided, you know, I need to get myself back in shape, and you went to the gym, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take it step by step. You're not going to go in there and lift up the heaviest weights or spend 2 hours on the treadmill. You're going to, say, do what you can, 5 minutes on the treadmill, you know, start with some light weights and just work it up bit by bit. You know that's going to be the case. And it's the same in business. You know, you can't expect that everything's just going to fall into place right now. But while you're in your current situation, what you need to be doing is laying a foundation by laying an aim. Write down what it is you want. What does your ideal life look like? What do you actually want out of this game of life? Do some personal inventory and some personal investment into yourself. Use this time to think what courses you can be doing. Use this time to really assess what your gifts and your strengths are. And then begin to find gainful employment little by little in the things that you love, and the things that are going to give you as an individual real fulfillment and a real sense of meaning and purpose in your life. And then, you know, adopt all the other things we've talked about. Find ways of incorporating this into your long-term strategy. Have a long-term strategy. It's not about like having a five-year aim or 10-year aim. This is deeper than that, because you have a five-year aim and then things change or whatever the case would be. I'm talking about laying a foundation for your entire approach to this thing, which means that you're going through stages. Everything you're doing is to take you up to the next level. Everything you're doing is adding to you, is increasing you, and is enlarging your capacity to be able to do more bit by bit. So I hope you've understood what I've been talking about. This is the Idea of a Man podcast. We've been talking about being a businessman. Next week, we're going to continue this conversation, and we're going to be talking really about, you know, finding your passion. What is your side hustle? We're going to dig into that area a little bit more and kind of explore how to really use your gift, your intrinsic, you know, thing that's key to who you are. We're going to look at that for a little bit. So I hope you've enjoyed this podcast. Leave your comments below. I'd love to hear from you. I really would. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. Subscribe to my podcast. Subscribe to my website. Thank you very much indeed for your time. Have a wonderful rest of the week.